You can import pre-map data from comma-separated or tab-separated files. Pre-mapped means that the records in the load file include account IDs that determine the reconciliations that they map to. You can import source system and subsystem balances, as well as transactions, such as invoices or journals data. Let's start by importing data for pre-map balances. The column headings required in files for pre-map balances are reconciliation account ID, currency code, and amount. You select the period, the balance type, source or subsystem, and the currency bucket for the data at the time of import. Administrators and power users can perform data loads from either the periods list or the reconciliations list. Preparers can perform data loads only from the reconciliations list. When power users and preparers import pre-map data, the import only affects reconciliations to which they have access. I'll import data for balances starting from the periods list. You initiate the import from the Actions menu of the period for which you want to load data. You can import balances into periods with pending, open, or closed status. I'll import balances into a period with pending status. You select a load file, and then you specify the balance type, the currency bucket, and the delimiter. You can import balances into reconciliations with any status. For reconciliations with open with a reviewer or closed status, if balances change as a result of the import, the reconciliation status reverts to open with preparer. If balances do not change, the reconciliation status is not affected. I'll start the import process. You can check for errors and warnings using the View Data Load Results option. For large data loads that may take some time to complete, you can close the Import Pre-map Data dialog box and return later to view the load results. When you import pre-map balances, previously imported pre-map balances are replaced. Balances loaded using data management are not affected. Now let's load pre-map transactions. Required columns and files for pre-map transactions are reconciliation account ID and an amount and currency column for at least one currency bucket. The column names for the entered currency bucket are amount 1 and amount currency 1. For the functional currency bucket, amount 2 and amount currency 2, and for the reporting bucket, amount 3 and amount currency 3. In the example file, data is loaded to the entered currency bucket. If the reconciliation does not use historical rates, and you've entered exchange rates, the amount for the lowest level currency bucket is the only amount that needs to be imported. The others will be calculated using the exchange rates. The file may also include columns for other transactions attributes. Now I'll import pre-map transactions from the reconciliations list. You select the load file, and then select the transaction type and the period. When you import pre-map transactions, previously imported pre-map transactions are replaced. Those include transactions previously imported through either this dialog, Smart View, or data integration. Reconciliations with open with a reviewer or closed status revert to open with preparer status. Transactions previously imported using the import option in the reconciliation dialog box and manually entered transactions are not affected. I'll start the import process. When the import is complete, the results are displayed. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.